this session so that you can go through these videos later. The size of the video is one of the issue. That's why I couldn't send you all these videos. Even I have the videos of all, you know, the multiple integral and all the other stuff also. But the issue is the size. I tried to, minimize the size, but it was like from 2.5 GB to 1.5 GB. That's it. Still 1.5 GB is bigger. Send over the network. Okay. Cool. So, yeah. Good morning once again. Okay. Shall we start?
Yes.
Okay. Cool. So, let me share my screen. Now I'm a little bit scared from, you know, the news which I heard about my uncle. Seriously, now I'm not going outside even for the essential service.
Yeah. So in fact, this family friend who passed away, he never stepped out of his house because he knew that his immunity wasn't that great, and his wife could just go in the lift. Literally from the lift, she got it, and nothing. He's unaffected, but she was a carrier. Give it to him.
Oh, why not? That may be the case. Yeah. It's very dangerous nowadays. So let me share my screen. Yeah, we are done with differential. Today we'll be talking about some questions on differential, and then we'll extend our topic to chain rule. Fine? Okay. Yeah. Everything fine? You can see the page, right?
Yeah.
Okay, cool. So see, we talk about differential in the previous class, and the differential was, it is the measurement of the height, change in height of the dependent function, right? Of the main function. Change in height, and that is approximated. That change in height is basically delta z, right? And that is approximated by dz, right? And that was fx dx plus fy dy that we have seen so far, right? Where dx is change in x, dy is change in y. Those are independent variable. So independent variable, the change is same as dx, right? Dx and dy. And fx, fy is the partial derivative of the function with respect to x and with respect to y.
Correct.
Okay. So the dz is basically the approximate value in change in height of the function. Okay. Now let's solve one question. We already solved one question based on this. Now we'll extend. We'll solve few questions and then we'll move to chain rule. Okay. So write down first question. Second question. Pressure of a certain gas can be described by P is equal to 8.314 T upon V. Okay, this is a very famous, which law? Gas law, Boyle's law, right? I think Boyle's law.
Yeah.
Am I right?
When all three of them are there, they call it the universal gas law.
Okay, yeah. The gas law. There, I think there are two laws, no? Boyle's and Chaul's, when we keep one of the variable constant, maybe. When we keep b constant, I think.
Yeah.
Like that. I remember something. You will be shocked that if I tell you I am graduating chemistry.
Oh, wow. Wow.
I think Mano knows that.
Yeah, I know.
Pure chemistry, sir.
Yeah. But it was like from 2004 to 4 to 7 batch. 2004 to 2007. But why I'm teaching maths? Basically, I love maths. That's why. But I know a lot of things like in chemistry, everything. No term is left. But I don't like teaching physics and chemistry. I like reading them. Okay.
Yeah.
So find dp, and if volume goes from 20 liter to 20.2 liter, and temperature from 300K to 295K. Find approximate change in pressure. Okay, so we have to find dp, that is the approximate. See, the word has been used here, that is approximate change in p, right? P is the main function, p is the dependent variable here. T and b are two independent variables. So I think you can, by own, you can solve this, because what we have to find out, we have to find out dp, and dp is pt dt plus pv dv, right? This is actually the formula we got. Am I right?
I just have a question.
Yeah.
I know we've gone over all of this,
yes.
But what is the the conceptual difference if you just plug in the initial value
and the final value.
And stuff.
So basically,
what is the conceptual difference?
Yeah, you will definitely get del p by plugging the values directly, because
correct.
The initial value is given 20 L,
yeah.
300K. 20.2 and 295K final values. So we can definitely find out del p, but the main application of this whole concept is not figuring out the del p basically. Are you getting that? This is just one question I'm putting here so that we can know how to apply the thing, right? But this is not the main application. What is the main application of differential? I think you guys know that. What is the main application of differential?
To find out
to find the uncertainty and the that kind of
error,
the experimental error.
Yeah, to find error, right? To find error. So this dp, if you, there are different kind of error, which is relative error, percentage error. So if dp upon p is the case, right? So we can certainly find dp upon p as the relative error, right? If we do that multiplication by 100, so that will give us the percentage error. So the main purpose of differential is to find the error in the main function, okay? Error in the rise. What is the error? We are not here to find the actual rise of the function. What is the error in that? So if once we find dp, we can certainly find the relative error and the percentage error based on the error present in dependent variable, which is t and b over here. Okay, so that is the main concept. This is just I put this to just how to find dp. The next question would be definitely based on the error concept. Is it clear, Manu?
Yeah.
Sure.
Yeah. What is the arithmetic that we do over here?
Arithmetic. You can use calculator for the final calculation. We are finding partial derivative. What arithmetic you are asking, Manu? I didn't get that. We are doing partial derivative and we are putting dt that directly. That dt, what is dt here? Can you say that? What is dt? What is dt? And what is dv? Just a second. Hello. Yeah. Okay. What is dt and what is dv? Dv in this case?
dv are partial derivatives of each other respectively,
no,
right?
These are changed. No.
Yeah. So dt will be.
These are change in temperature, change in volume. And that change is same as delta t and delta v. Do you understand this? I think you have. See, recall that diagram. Let me show you the diagram. Manu, just go through. See this. Del y and del x are same as dy dx. Are you getting
dy
dx? Yeah. Right. So those are independent variable. Similarly, what is dt and dv here? Uh-huh. That is same as change in temperature, change in volume.
Correct. So dt is equal to delta t, dv is equal to delta v.
Yeah.
Delta, which is equal to, is equal to only the change, which is
final five. Minus initial.
Minus 5 or 5?
Final minus initial. That is the change. So minus 5. And dv is 0.2. Okay. Did you understand that? Dv is 0.2 and dt is minus 5.
Yeah. That I got. Okay. So now we just substitute in the.
So just a clarification, you substitute in when you're substituting v and t, you substitute the new v and t, right?
Initial value. We substitute, I just write it down here. For V, we substitute 300K and for T, we substitute 300K and for V, we substitute 20L. That what you're asking?
Yeah.
Okay. We always substitute the initial value.
Okay.
Actually, this is also one of the law. Do you know that? This the equation which I proposed here, that is also one of the law.
One of the laws meaning?
This is one of the formula proposed by one of the scientists. I think Gauss law.
Oh, okay. But this has got nothing to do with the partial pressure. No? That's a very different concept.
Yeah, that's different concept. Partial pressure is bifurcated into the dimension which is there in the object. Okay, so should I solve this, Manu? What is PV? Can you tell me what is PV? I just write it down here so that you can cross-check that. Is it what you got? Minus 8.314 T upon V square.
So PV means partial of V. Okay.
Partial derivative with respect.
PT means
partial derivative with respect to T, keeping V constant.
Yeah. Then
Okay, so I got an answer.
Are you slight confused here, Manav? See, whenever we, with respect to x, x is the variable, and the other thing are constant.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, I got that one.
Okay. So what would be, delta p, which is approximate value, as dp? What value you got here? What is the answer?
You changed to 8 from 3.
8.314, that is.
Yeah. I wrote it as the old one. You had first written 3.314.
No, that's 8.314.
Oh,
universal gas constant.
Achha, I read that as.
No,
but I wrote that as 3. Yeah, okay. Okay.
And so we substitute, when we substitute 8.314 over V into dt, which is minus 5, that V will be the new V, right?
No, initial value. You always substitute for initial value.
So the change is 8.314 over 20 into.
And that change is dealt with dt 5. And dv.
Minus 3.3256.
Yes, right. Minus 3.3256. What would be the unit? Pascal.
The Pascal.
It's a unit of pressure is Pascal.
And meter cube is equal to a liter, right?
Yes. 1 liter is equal to 1 meter cube.
Yeah.
A lot of such formula. 1 dm cube.
What is the answer?
Did you get the answer, Manu? Minus 3.3256.
No.
Why?
One second.
DP is equal to.
Typed it wrong.
8.314. Yes. Over 20. V is 20 into DT. DT
into
is
minus 5.
DT is minus 5.
Minus 5. Plus minus
8.314.
8.314.
T. T is also there.
400.
And DV is 0.2. Did you miss T there? Let me replace that V square and T. So V square and T is V square is 400.
Old T, right? Okay.
Yeah, old T.
300. Old T. Okay.
So 1 meter cube is 1,000 liters.
1,000 liter, no? See, I was wondering that. I think 1 dm cube would be there.
Then
1 dm cube is 1 liter.
It may not become.
1 dm cube is 1 liter.
Yeah, but might not become SI units. You'll have to convert them, I think. No?
Which one?
To make it Pascal, our final answer in Pascal.
Yeah.
That liter will have to be made to meter, right?
Liter. Okay. Where we have used liter? Liter is used here. Okay.
Yeah.
So liter is not SI unit?
And
liter is not SI unit?
No. Okay. Meter cube you'll have to make it SI unit, it's meter cube.
Okay.
But so it's okay. I mean,
you can work on that. You can work on that. Maybe.
Yeah.
I'm still confused about liter, because I think one dm cube and 1 liter both are SI unit. If you take one dm cube or 1 liter, then what would be the SI unit of volume? Meter cube, you are saying 1 meter cube, right? So 1 dm cube will be changed to
1 meter cube.
Yeah.
SI unit is meter cube.
Yeah. So you have to convert this 1 dm cube to 1 meter cube. That what you are saying, right? Well, liter is there.
Meaning, yeah, do the conversion, but sir, it doesn't matter.
Yeah, yeah. So you can figure it out later.
1000 dm cube is 1 meter cube.
Mm-hmm. Okay, fine. So now you can write the actual use of differential. Otherwise, you will just figure out it is just to use change in the main function. It's not like that. It is to find the max error, maximum error in the function while measuring the independent variable. Okay, and you can say, like, you can write summary about that error. Maybe, you know, error may be given in terms of percentage. So maximum percentage error is equal to del f upon f, and that is same as df upon f. Okay, so this is actual use of differential. Now, based on this, I will be putting one question. Okay. So the question is, write down question. Tension T of a cable at its lowest point is given by T is equal to WL square upon 8A. All quantity you must know. W is weight. Okay. L is length of. Okay, I'm giving you the diagram here. That L. Suppose this is the bridge we are talking about, London Bridge.
Suspension bridge.
Yeah. L is the length of the bridge. Okay. And A is your. A is basically the tension applied here at this point, and A is this distance. Okay, and W is weight of road. Weight of the road in pound per feet, like that. So we have to figure out what is the percentage error in T. Okay, the percentage error is given already for W. That is plus minus 1%, L plus minus 2%, and A plus minus 2%. So these are the percentage error given, and we have to find out the percentage error in T. Okay, so we can done.
We actually used to do these type of questions in physics in IB.
There we directly use the formula, right?
Yeah, we didn't understand what was behind it. We just did it like that mechanically.
Yeah. When the physics teacher also proposed the formula directly without knowing the derivative concept of that.
Yeah.
It should be 7%, right?
Wow, awesome, Manu. I'm so happy. Right. So percentage error in.
We used to get this in.
Okay.
Yeah.
So that
I've not done my working yet.
How did you get that then?
MCQ we used to do. We know the rules of calculate uncertainty.
Okay. Good. So the answer is 7%.
I know the working. Basically, we did. We used to use the delta f upon f part and modulus of that. We used to do that part, not the differential part.
Okay. So you apply the partial
derivative.
Okay. Now you apply the partial derivative and all partial derivative concept to find the differential, and then you can find the relative error, and then you just find the terms in percentage. Mano always used to shock me, even in IB also.
What?
Mano always.
So, but this, like, even I tried to.
Go ahead.
Even I tried using like what we had learned in like physics. And I don't know, I'm not getting 7. I'm getting.
Mano will explain.
I mean,
I think Mano will explain.
If I'm not getting. Mano, can you explain more?
What? Explain what?
How did you get 7%?
Like, I tried using it only not much. I must have.
Your voice is very soft in my system. I can can't hear you. Hello?
Yeah, I can hear you. Mano,
just now, Mano, you are teacher for 2 minutes. You have to explain how did you get 7% directly to Deo.
And without the differential.
Without
using
differential concept.
Laws of uncertainties, I just use that. So basically we know omega, is that omega or W? W is plus minus 1%.
Yeah.
Okay, and when it's a fraction, using laws of uncertainties, we just have to add the individual uncertainties. So it is
correct.
1 plus 4 plus 6.
Yeah.
1 plus 4 plus 6, yeah. And if you use logic also, even intuitively, if you know that this is 0.01, that is 0.02 into 0.02, and that is also 0.02.
One second.
So basically,
it is
1 plus 4 plus 6.
How did you get 6? Ah. Oh, calculation mistake. So dumb. Mm-hmm. Yeah. I got 1 plus 4. Oh god, I messed it up. Okay.
Now apply maths also.
Could you show the differential steps? I got the arithmetic.
Okay.
I'm getting the arithmetic. The steps I'm not getting.
Okay. So
what steps do we have to show?
Yeah. See, the first of all, the formula is dt. Dt is basically, you know, what formula we have to apply here. What the function is t, right? So t, l and a, right? So l dt plus t with respect to a da, right? W is also there, plus t with respect to w,
yeah,
dw.
Okay, right. So the first step in all model problems is that we write the differential statements with all the variables involved,
all,
right?
All the variables involved. There are three independent variables. We have to put all three. So partial derivative will goes with respect to all three
independent. Yeah. Got it. Yeah.
So yeah, right.
So we get omega L two W L upon it A. And dt is just change in t, which is
L square upon 8a dw. Okay, first term I have written here, plus 2w upon 8a l.
Sir, why?
Dl.
So why have you written?
Sir, shouldn't it be 2wl upon 8a?
Yeah, it's there. 2w.
First term.
First, I have written with respect to W. See, this term I have written there. First term.
Oh, okay. No, I thought you were going
check DW.
No, sir. I'm seeing in that line you've written TLDT. Shouldn't it be TLDL?
TLDL, yeah.
D?
Sorry. I have written D. Right. TLDL. Plus, in fact, minus WL square upon 8A square DA. Okay, so did you get these terms?
Yeah.
Approximate value of delta T. So what we'll do here, see, once we get DT here, what we should do? We will divide throughout by what?
8. We multiply throughout
t, by 8. T. No, our purpose is to find this. Do you understand? Dt by t. We got dt here. So divide throughout by t. Okay? Divide by t. So when you divide this by t, okay? Then put it in mod also, because if this follows, so the mod also follows the rule. So L square upon 8a dw upon t. What is t? T is the formula which is given to us, which is W L square upon 8a plus 2w upon 8a upon W L square upon 8a. L is also there. DL minus WL square upon 8A square upon WL square upon 8A DA, right? Is it okay? Now, if you cancel the terms, you can see that you can cancel every term except W here. You can cancel every term except L. The constant would be there. That will check it out. And you can cancel every term except A. Okay. WL square will cancel out. 8 will also cancel out. 1A will also cancel out. So what will be remain here that we have to write down? So DW upon
W
plus, we can separate the mod also, plus 2 dot dl upon l plus minus da upon a. Okay, so what is dw by w? We have given percentage error here, right? So from this percentage error we can calculate the relative error, right? So w percentage error is 1%. So dw by w is equal to 1%, which is 0.01, right? Similarly, dl by l
right.
is equal to 0.02. See, plus minus gone because I have put modulus. Okay, the total maximum error, possible maximum error, it will goes either left hand side or right hand side. Left hand side, right hand side means either you can overestimate or you can underestimate the value, right? And dA upon A is equal to 0.02. So the data can be fetched out from the given thing here, and you can use those data. So what is dW by W? Plus minus, you can, I have already applied modulus there, so you can remove modulus. So dW by W is 0.01 plus 2 into 0.02 plus, see, the minus sign will be plus here, and dA by dA is again 0.02. So if you add them, you will get 2 to the 4, so 0.07.
0.07%.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. Done? Okay. Now the next important concept is chain rule. We'll be doing chain rule. Chain rule. So I hope you know the basic chain rule about one independent variable. We had this concept in derivative also. We already done that. You know how to figure out or how to apply chain rule. Okay. You know how to figure out the derivative of the function, which is the independent function. You know, independent variable is also dependent on something. So that doesn't become independent then. Are you getting what I'm saying? So if we have y is equal to, let's say, sine x raised to 5. Okay. So for chain rule, what we assume here, that if suppose we replace this x raised to 5 by u or t. Okay. So u is equal to x raised to 5. So y become sine u. Right. Y becomes sine u. So here, u itself dependent on x. U itself dependent on x. So x is the, you know, x is the independent variable, and u is what? What is u? U will give you the pathways to approach x. Like what we basically find out, we find out dy by dx, isn't it? We used to find out dy by dx, derivative of y with respect to x. But the function y is not directly related with x. Like you can see that this is directly related with x. But as far as the chain rule is concerned, what do? We replace x raised to 5 by u. And once you get this function, so y is directly related to u now. Are you getting that? So u will give you the pathway to approach x, right? And u become, you know, u become the intermediate variable. U become the intermediate variable. Or temporary variable, we assume. Okay. So u become the intermediate variable, which gives us the pathways to approach x. So derivative of y with respect to x, what is the chain rule? Derivative y with respect to x is derivative y with respect to u into derivative u with respect to x, right? And we assume that u will cancel out. We assume, we used to learn this formula by considering derivative is that du part is cancelled out. It doesn't happen directly. Okay. Fine. So this is the formula in terms of one independent variable. Now we are talking about the variable function, right? We have been talking about multivariable function. So we'll have to check how to apply chain rule in multivariate function, right? So if suppose, say this goes on, sometimes, you know, we have chain rule in terms of three variable also, isn't it? Like if suppose function, we may have three variable also, which involve x, y, z, like that. So the formula become like this. It depends upon how much independent variable you have. So dy by du, du by, you know, dt, and then dt by then dx, right? So this also a type of formula we have observed already. Am I right?
Yeah.
Means if you just simply, yeah, if you simply put this, this function y is equal to inside, okay, I just don't complicate it more. If I do this way, raised to 5, so this become, you know, this type of three variable kind of, or there would be, you know, three such term involved like this. Are you getting that now? Let's discuss about the multivariable function. Chain rule in, what do you think, like what your sixth sense says, what would be if suppose the function is w is equal to x square minus y square, okay, and x is dependent on t, so x is equal to t square plus 1 and y is equal to t cube plus t, okay. Suppose this is the function, where must have gone?
I must have gone to the bathroom.
Yeah, okay. Didn't stop me and I didn't see him.
Charger.
Okay, so what your sixth sense says as far as the chain rule is concerned here, What would you apply? How would you apply a chain rule in this? Any idea? Or any guess? Because we have already talked about partial derivative.
Yeah, partial derivative.
Yeah, go ahead.
So if you substitute the ones with the values with the t into the w one. So like t square plus 1 whole squared minus that t cube plus t whole squared, and then you get dw dt
in terms of t.
And then and then you, for the individual ones, you get the dx.
Apply the
diagram dx dt.
See what we are finding here. We are finding dw by dt, right? This is the concept. Okay, now I'll explain you the concept. We know that dw by dt is equal to limit t tends to 0, not t tends to 0, delta t tends to 0, okay, and dw by delta w upon delta t, right? This is the actual definition of the derivative, but this is not directly applicable for the multivariable function, okay? So I'll explain you the concept. See, we have already discussed the partial derivative yesterday. In previous class we discussed about the differential. What was the differential? Differential means we try to figure out delta w, and that is approximated by dw, right? That we have seen in differential. So what was the concept of differential? Do you remember that? What was the concept of differential? The concept of differential was the total rise in the function, okay, the total rise in the function is bifurcated in two ways, right? One is along x direction, and then once we approach certain point, then we go along y direction. Okay, so and the rise continuously, we are rising also. Continuously we are rising also, isn't it? So when we go along x direction, we have certain rise. Okay, that's not the complete rise basically. And then we go along y direction, that would have certain rise. So that complete rise is basically the sum of these two rise in the function. Are you with me?
Yeah.
Okay. So I'll try to put this concept here. Okay. First of all, what let's understand the variable part of this. What is x and y here? And what is t? Let's understand the name. Name we should, we have to use the name. Yeah.
X and y are the independent variables. W is the dependent variable, and t is the parameter.
So now we'll change the name a little bit. X and y is our intermediate variable. Okay, and there is only one independent variable, that is t. Right?
T. Yeah.
So x and y are intermediate variable and t is the independent variable. So how many dependent, how many total variables are there here? How many total variables?
I mean
four.
Three, right?
There are four total variable. Okay, one is always dependent. The first main function is always dependent variable, right? W is dependent variable. X and y are intermediate variable, and only one independent variable is there, that is t here in this case. Okay, so we have to find out dw by dt. That is the purpose of this. So I'll try to give you the proof of how to find out dw by dt and the formula of that, what formula is look like and how we can approach to that formula. So I'm trying to give you the little bit proof about that. Okay, so we know one thing, that as we change the value of t, what will happen? If we change the value of t, what will happen?
If you change the value of t, all the other value of all the other three variables will change.
If you change the value of t, x and y will change, and as x and y changes, w will also change.
W,
right? So you can write that as t changes, means delta t, x and y respond by changing also, and that is delta x and delta y. Okay, and both delta x and delta y cause a change in w, that is delta w, right? Very simple statements. Okay. So, what is d del w, delta w? What is delta w basically? That is the complete rise in the function, right? I always say rise because you will refer the diagram in your mind. Okay, I would have said change. Rise has picture, change we cannot imagine picture always, right? So delta w is basically the complete rise in the function, right? So delta w is the amount, you know, the amount x changes w. So we go in x direction first. Okay, we go along x direction, and then what happened when we changes x, what happened to w? Plus, because then we have to go along y direction as well. So the amount y changes w. Are you getting that? So this is two scenario. There we can see the changes is happening, the rise is happening in dependent variable or in the main function. Okay, so how to find out the, you know, the rise, how to find out the rise along x direction, how to find out the rise along x direction. So do you recall this rise upon run is equal to derivative of the function with respect to x. So what, yeah, sorry, I didn't hear you.
X direction, the change is only the rise is only the change in y, right?
No, change in x. Y is kept constant along x direction. So we differentiate the function. See, do you understand one thing? See, we you have picture, right? In your mind, you have picture. So if suppose, okay, I show you the picture. See, in this figure, what is the rise in the function along x direction? That is delta zx, delta zx. Are you getting that? That is the rise along x direction.
Yeah.
And delta zy, that is the rise along y direction. So what did we write for delta zx and for delta zy? So that is basically from this concept, isn't it? That slope is equal to rise upon run. Yeah. So you always find out rise in terms of, you know, it's not visible, just a second. Oh, it's not visible. No,
no,
so there's no change in what
just a second. So I was referring this diagram. So the question was, what is delta zx, right? Can you see now? Can you see? I have referred the pages from differential. Yeah. So what is delta zx? So dzx, which is the rise along x direction, and dzy, that is the rise along y direction. So that is basically dzx is equal to fx dx and dzy is fy dy. Mm-hmm. So the same thing we are discussing here also.
Yeah.
So we'll write down the formula, and that is the main function w we consider, but we'll write it in terms of w then. So del w, that is partial derivative, right? Del w upon del x into what? Into delta x, right? Slope, partial derivative into run. Are you getting that? Partial derivative into run.
Yeah.
We are finding rise always. So partial derivative with respect to x and run, that will give you the rise, right? Plus partial derivative with respect to y. Now we'll go along y direction, and the slope into run will give you the rise. Vector addition also you can consider, no? Vector addition. That's the, suppose this is along y direction I'm going. Okay. So this is the slope. This is the slope. This is the slope. This is the run. So rise plus run will give you the rise. Slope plus run will give you rise. Okay. So slope into run rise. The formula also. This formula you can refer.
Yeah.
Into delta y. Okay. So now what we'll do here, what we are trying to find out, dw by dt, isn't it? What we are finding, dw by dt. So what we'll do here, we'll divide by delta t. Okay, we'll divide by delta t throughout. So delta w upon delta t is equal to delta w upon delta x into delta x upon delta t plus delta y upon delta t. Right, delta t is just finite value, we can simply divide anyway. This is just an algebra. Delta t is finite value, that's not zero. Are you getting that? I'm not dividing that by dt.
Yeah.
Even dt is finite value. In fact, dt is also finite because we always have two points. You understand that? While explaining differential, we never overlap the points. We always have two points, whatever the distance between them. The distance would be very close. The distance would be very small. That doesn't matter, but we always have two points. Okay. So we are dividing each term by delta t here. And then what we take basically, we let delta t tends to zero. That is the concept of derivative,
right?
Isn't it? We let delta t tends to zero by putting limit. So limit, I have written this, you know, here. Okay, I love that. So limit delta t tends to zero, delta w upon delta t is equal to limit delta t tends to zero, delta x upon delta t plus limit delta t tends to zero, delta y, del y, del delta, everything so confusing, delta y upon delta t, del delta d, lot of terms involved all together. Okay, so now this left hand side is nothing but your dw by dt, which is derivative of w with respect to t, and since this term can be taken outside, del w by del x and if you apply limit, okay, let me write that, limit delta t tends to zero, delta x by delta t plus, I will take that term outside, in limit delta t tends to zero, delta y upon delta t. So the final formula is dw by dt is equal to, and this this is dx by dt plus, are you getting that? This is dy by dt, not delta, dy. This is dy by dt. How many derivatives are involved here?
Five.
Yeah, derivative, five derivative involved basically. The terms, there are five terms.
I'm counting the partial.
Yeah, I got it. So, two are partials. In fact, this is the final. This we should not call count in this dw by dt that we are figuring out, right? So there are basically four derivative we have to perform. Two are partial. Two are not partial, regular.
3 are, right? 3 are partial and 2 are complete.
2 are partial, 2 are complete.
Yeah.
Partial y also, not omega x and y, right?
There are four derivative are performing, you know? Only these four. Among them, 2 are partial, 2 are complete. Right? Are you with me? So this is the the derivative based on chain rule. Did you imagine this concept before when I asked you what would be the chain rule in multivariable function? It is about partial derivative with respect to x into run, then partial derivative with respect to y into run, right? That concept will give you the derivative of w with respect to t. Okay, now the question was, I had given you one question. The question was w is equal to x square minus y square, x is equal to t square plus 1, y is equal to t square plus t. So you simply find out these four terms, right? Two of them are partial, two of them are complete. So whenever two variable involved, always think that way. Whenever two variable involved means there are two independent variable, basically they now it become two intermediate variable. But whenever the function is dependent on two variable, we always find the partial derivative. Okay. And then when the function is dependent on only one variable, we find the complete derivative. That's it. Right. So del w upon del x, del w upon del y. So what is del w upon del x? 2x. What is del 2x. W upon del y?
Minus 2y.
And dx by dt, 2t. And dy by dt,
2t plus 1.
Yes. Now we can simply substitute to figure out dw by dt. See, if I directly put this formula, you wouldn't understand the logic behind that, actually. You know, I would have directly put the formula partial derivative into complete derivative plus partial derivative with respect to y into complete derivative with respect to t, but it doesn't make sense. But now you can always refer the diagram, which along x direction, along y direction, the complete rise is in two ways like that. Okay. So 2x into 2t plus minus 2y into dy by, I think then that would be, okay, 2t, just a second, what it would be, 2t plus 1, right?
Plus 1.
Yeah. It's, right?
It's 4xt minus 40y plus 2y.
Okay, you simplify that. Okay, no problem. So that would be 4xt minus 2y.
4y.
I just write it down there. You know that. Okay. Now we'll summarize the idea. You know, we'll summarize the idea. We'll summarize the idea. What is the idea to figure out the chain, to apply the chain rule in multivariable function? So we'll represent that in terms of tree diagram. Tree diagram is, suppose the main function is w here. Okay, the main function is w. There are how many intermediate variables? There are two intermediate variables, x and y. Okay, and independent variable. How many independent variable? only one, that is t, isn't it? So you can refer this diagram always, that's really helpful. We have to approach t from w, so that can be achieved in two ways. One is along x direction, one is along y direction. Okay, so whenever there are two variables involved, we are approaching x from w first, right? And we have two options available, either one direction along x direction, the other is along y direction. We have two options available. Whenever we have two options available, what we write? We write partial derivative. Okay, and when we have only one option available, like we are approaching t from x, only one option is there, dt. So that would be dx by dt, complete derivative. Okay, so the formula you can directly put like this. Fine.
So you mean dx dt, no?
Yeah, sorry. See, it's so confusing is this, right? Even I know the concept, I'm saying the same thing, I'm writing that, but while writing, I'm putting the partial derivative. Okay. I'm putting one question here based on this. Yeah.
So I was looking through one of those past papers just like that.
Yeah.
And I remember coming across one question where they said that the is equal to open bracket. Set t square plus 1 comma and like t to the power 5 or something. So like, is that kind of the concept that x and y was like, I don't, like every point was different.
So this is one of the parameter, okay, the independent variable, and like what we have been doing here, see, x and see this is x comma y, sometimes they write that way, you know, in bracket. So if suppose you write in bracket, that is x coordinate and y coordinate, so x is equal to t square plus 1 and y is equal to t raised to 5, so that way sometimes the parametric equations are represented. So they simply try to put this in the coordinate system like this. Is it what you are asking? Like, did I clarify?
But sir, how do you combine the x and y to create one function? You can't, right?
No, we can, but we must given some idea behind how to combine. See, suppose if suppose these points are on one of the graph, right? Either parabola, ellipse, circle, whatever. So we must have certain idea. Okay, because these are the set rules, right? These are the set rules. The rules is like x square plus y square is equal to r square, right? This is also one of the set rules. Y is equal to 4ax square. X square upon a square plus y square upon b square is equal to 1. So these are set rules. So where we can apply this coordinates to figure out the relation between x and y. Okay, so we must have some certain set rules, okay, where we can put these values, then only we can figure out the relation between x and y.
Okay.
Where are we on this 114 Devash?
Yeah, this is 114. Oh, how far are we? I think we've done quite a bit, but like we have the whole, obviously the whole integration part left, which is like a big chunk.
What is our overall goal now?
I'll finish
114, right?
I'll let you know what we are left with. I'll let you know. We are doing chain rule here, right? Then we go for maximum and minimum saddle points, okay? Of multivariable function, we used to say saddle points.
We have given you 114 details, right? We've given set the details, right?
I got that, but I know one thing that it is even similar everywhere. It is similar everywhere. Don't worry about that. You have to bring multiple integration. I generally don't go in detail, basically. I know there's some. A lot of things are mentioned there, but since we are going in this direction right now, so I know what need to be covered. Are you getting that?
Yeah.
So this chain rule, once we are covered with multiple integration, and then I will look back to the, you know, the syllabus prescribed by Deva, and then according to that we'll go. Because I know these things are there in that. Mm. Without these things, how would you study calculus? These are the basic fundamentals.
Yeah, yeah. These are the basic concepts.
Right? Yes.
Correct.
Yeah.
Okay. Yes. Even I'll give you some, you know, after finishing this chapter, the derivative chapter, basically, I'll give you some question which are given by the Chicago University Math Department. I have the collection. Okay. So I'll giving you that thing, which is very much similar to this. What we are studying right now. Okay, so I'm putting one question based on this. The question is, if W is equal to x square y minus xy cube, x is equal to cos t, y is equal to e raised to t. Okay, see, this x and y are given in terms of t, okay, and we must have certain rule which associate x and y together to get the main function, okay.
Mm.
Okay, so what we have to do, we have to find dw by dt at t is equal to 0. Just do it.
So that formula we learned is universal, right?
Yes, yes, definitely. We have some extension of this. We'll be doing after this question. We have some extension, right? Because there may be three intermediate variables. There may be two independent variables, right?
So done.
What's the answer?
Oh, sorry. I have the last step left. One second.
Okay.
The answer, sir, is x square minus 3xy square.
See, for t, I think you didn't find the value for t equal to 0. What is the value of x?
I found when.
For t equal to 0, x is 1.
Oh, and that also.
Yeah. So 2.
Yeah,
for t equal to
if 0. If I am putting independent variable as constant, you must get constant because you are getting independent variable constant. All are dependent on that. You will always get constant.
So the answer is minus 2 then.
Minus 2, right. Perfect.
One into zero plus one minus two
I write the formula here, dw by dt is equal to 2xy minus yq into minus sin t plus x square minus 3xy square et. Is that okay? Now when you substitute the value,
yeah,
you get dw by dt at t is equal to 1, x is equal to 1, t equal to 0, x is equal to 1, y is equal to 1, is equal to minus 2. Okay, now let's extend this topic to to different ideas. If suppose we have, okay, let me write that first, extending the concept. So the extension is based on two idea. One is if we have more intermediate variable, okay, in the previous example there were two intermediate variables x and y. If suppose we have z also in the picture, the function can be dependent on 3, 4, whatever, it depends. So if we have more intermediate variable, or the second scenario is if more independent variable, more independent variable. Okay, so for the first scenario, more intermediate variable, can you draw the tree diagram? Because that tree diagram is really helpful to figure out the formula. So if suppose we have, like I give you the example. See, the example could be W is equal to tan inverse XZ plus Z upon Y. Okay, where X is equal to T, Y is equal to T square, Z is equal to sin T. So this is one of the question. Now we have to figure out dW by dt. Okay, dW by dt. So this type of question comes, then what would be the formula? So we just write down the, we make tree diagram. W is the main function. X, Y, Z are three intermediate variable, and T is independent variable. Okay. There are three ways to approach.
So it is the partial del x by del w by del x, del w by del y, del w by del z, then dx by dt, dy by dt, dz by dt.
Yes, so it makes very easy, right? It makes to figure out the formula very easy. So dw by dt is equal
can
to
be always. Are there any scenarios?
Yeah, we may have different, we may have we may have more independent variable.
Can we generalize that all from main to intermediate we'll always do partial with respect to the main?
Yes,
with of the main with respect to the partial.
Yeah,
and so then that, always complete derivative from intermediate to the final one. So yes, we need to draw the tree diagram then, right?
No, if you can figure out directly, you can directly put the formula. But suppose
is that true?
Yeah, it's true.
Yeah,
it's definitely true. Okay, the main thing is if suppose we have more than one independent variable, and I'll give you the different scenario. But as far as this formula is concerned, like with respect to this question at least, we can directly write the formula if you can. And we always plus them. Huh? Now, what is the answer? Did you find that?
Oh, we have not started.
We have to simply write the terms. there is no constant term defined for t, so we can simply write the formula in terms of the partial derivative.
So, can you scroll up to the question, like, the sum? Yeah.
Tan inverse over 1 over 1 minus. Plus x squared, 1 over 1 plus.
We are doing part 2 from Math 114 calculus. We are doing part 2, functions of several variables. Vector valued function, partial derivative, and application, double and triple integral. So we'll be doing till triple integral, we'll be doing that way. Conic section, polar coordinates is the previous concept. Vector calculus, first order differential equation also there. Application to physics science, use of symbolic manipulation and graphic software. So this is first term, right? This is first term. Am I right, Dev? This is first term which you sent on the group. And for part three is the for second year, I think. Am I right?
Okay.
Part three. Maybe because also, yeah.
I'm not too sure, to be honest, about how the what the parts, what they mean, like, is it over semesters or over years or anything? But, you know, I'll ask the senior thing.
Okay, no, I'm telling based on my experience. Based on my experience, I'm telling that. Because the part two is for first year, maybe, and part two is for second year, I think. Okay, we'll see that later. Okay, did you find this?
So, I found it, but now I'm making everything in terms of t, even the like the delta, the partial derivatives, I'm making it in terms of t, right? After I solved it.
No, not required. Like, not required. Like, not required. You can, I just write it down. You can simply put the terms in terms of x, y, z, and later, if you want to convert into t, we know the formula. There is a relation in terms of x, y, and z.
Yeah.
In terms of t. Yeah. All those values are dependent on t also. So we know that. So we can simply put that instead of putting inside the function, we put it separately. So the answer, I'm just putting answer here directly so that you can cross check. Is it right? This is the final answer.
Yeah, I got this one.
Okay.
Yeah, I got
this one. Yeah.
Okay. So we'll be stopping here. Next time we'll start with fresh questions and the next concept of this chapter. Okay. So
we'll meet.
We'll meet on Wednesday, right?
Same.
We'll keep same time. Wednesday, same time. We'll keep.
Yeah. 11.
That's better, right?
And can we have a fixed time now on? Because actually, I need. There is work on above, so I've told them not to work because there's disturbance. So that time fixed, I've told them.
Okay.
So the drills and stuff.
Okay. So yeah, we'll keep the same.
11 is fixed.
11 fixed. Yeah. We'll keep
11 to 20. Unless something from comes up.
Yeah.
Monday, Wednesday, Friday.
Okay.
Okay.
Yeah. Bye bye. Be safe, Dev. Okay, Dev, be safe. You are going outside.
Yeah.
Be safe. Yes, okay. Bye bye.
Where is Dev going?
We'll go.
Guys.
Okay. Bye bye.
Bye guys. Thank you.
Bye. Thank you.